Let us start our chapter Database Query Using SQL. We have started the chapter in last class and we studied about the different functions of MySQL. They are math functions, date and time function, and string function. Now let us see. We have discussed about the math functions. And in that, we have done only few examples in the round function. So let us see the working of a round function. So let us run a select statement. So you can see this is a select statement in round function. If we run this, it will generate the output as, because in the rounds function there are two parameters. One is the number to be rounded and the number of digits it is to be rounded. So here only the number is given and the number of digits to be rounded is not given. So all the numbers after the decimal point will be rounded off to zero. So here 0 after the decimal point there is 0.34. It is rounded off and rounded off to a value which is a non-decimal value. So let us see if we give the value as 54. So we get the output as 349, because the value after the decimal is greater than 5. So if a value is greater than 5, it is rounded to a value, it is increased by 1 unit, and if it is less than 5, then the value is remains the same. So let us see one more example. Here I have provided the number of digits after decimal. So after rounding off, there will be one digit after the decimal point. So you can see 348.54. After the decimal point, there is one digit. It is 5. 5 will not be rounded off, because after 5, the number is 4, which is less than 5. If the number was 5, then the 5 will be rounded off to 6, because the number is greater than 5. So we can see another example with negative values, negative numbers. So if I provide a negative number, then the value before the decimal point will be made 0. So this number you can see is rounded off to 0, and this 5 has become, this 348 has become 350, because this 8 is the, we are rounding off, one digit is rounded to 0. So what happens is, if one digit, if here the value is 1, then the first digit before the decimal will be checked, and if it is greater than or equal to 5, then the digit before it will be incremented by one value. So this 348 has become 350. So same example we can consider. We can make this as 343. Now you can see this 343, 3 is less than that of 5. So the value 4 is not incremented, it remains the same. Now let us go on to the term function. What is a function? It is a set of predefined commands which when called, performs certain operations and returns a value. There are two types of functions. They are single row functions and multiple row functions. Single row functions are applied to each row in a table. In a table, each row will be applied with that function. Examples are our math functions, string functions, and date function. These are applied to each and every row of the table. Now, the next type of function is multiple row function, or aggregate function, or group function. These all you have studied in your 11th standard. So what is a group function? A group function is applied to a group. It is called aggregate function. Aggregate functions are applied to a group. So let us see what is an aggregate function. An aggregate function performs a calculation on a set of values and returns a single value. It is also called multiple row or group functions. There are mainly five aggregate functions. They are average, sum, max, min, and count. So let us see what are the different aggregate functions. So first aggregate function is the sum. Sum function is used to return the total of all the values present in a particular column. It is used to return the total of all the values present in a particular column. So we can calculate the total marks. So total marks will be a single value which is applied to a group. It always takes arguments based on integer data type. Since this is a function, the data inside the bracket parenthesis is called argument. So the sum function will have integer type of argument. So the sum function cannot be applied for name, date of birth, gender, but it can be applied only to columns like roll number, marks. Only integer values can be given to the sum function. So if we give some arguments like string and date to the sum function, it will say data are not defined. Sum of string and date data are not defined. Let us see the syntax of sum function. Select sum of column name from table name where condition. Let us see, there is a table called student, and we can provide the select statement as select. We want to calculate the total marks. For that we have to write the statement as select for the total marks function sum. Sum of which column denotes the marks? The marks column. So sum of marks from table name, that is student. So the sum function will, since inside the select statement what is given? Sum of marks. So the output will generate a column with the heading what is given in the select statement. So sum of marks, the column will have the heading sum of marks, and it will have only a single value because it is an aggregate function. So only a single value will be produced. So it will add up all the values and generate a value. Now, if we have to provide a condition, we can provide using the where clause. Select sum of marks from student where marks greater than 90. So we have to calculate only the total for those students whose marks are greater than 90. For that we will write select sum of marks from students where marks greater than 90. So only two students are there whose marks are greater than 90. So it will add up only these two values and give the total as sum of marks. It will add up these two values and display here. Hi children, let us see few examples of how the sum function works. So let us see, the sum aggregate functions are always given in the select statement. So select, we can give sum of marks. From student, you can see it calculates, it produces only a single result. It calculates all the add sum up all the values in the column mark. So the column name has to be specified in the function sum, and we can here no condition is provided. No where condition is given, so it calculates all the values. But if a where condition is given, then it calculates the sum based on the condition satisfied. So we can give a where condition where marks greater than 90. So here the sum will be calculated, but only for students whose marks are greater than 90. So you can see only two students are there whose marks are greater than 90. So their sum is calculated. And this sum will not calculate this, add up this null value. And sum function will not operate for the columns name and gender, date of birth, gender. It will operate only for integer data types or float data type. It will not work for character or varchar or date data types. Okay, let us see the next type of function, that is average function. So what is average function? It returns the average value of any column or expression. It always takes argument based on integer type. Average of string and date data are not defined, and null values are not included in the calculation. Whenever it detects a null value, it will exclude that and calculate the average based on the non-null values. So the syntax is select AVG of column name from table name where condition. So here we are given a table, in that we can find out the average of any column like roll number and marks. So we can calculate the average, select AVG of marks from table name, that is student. Then it will produce a single value for the average. It will add up all the values and divide it by 5. And produce a result, that is the average. Here no condition is given, but when we give a condition, we can give the condition based on where clause, in the where clause. So we can give a condition like select AVG of marks from student where marks greater than 90. Then it will consider only the values which are greater than 90 and compute its average. So we get the average as a single value. Because it is an aggregate function, it will produce only a single result as the output. So it obtains a single value as the result. So let us see how it works in MySQL. So in the same table, we can write here instead of sum, average. So it will return the average of all the marks. You can see it didn't include the null, because even though there is a person and her value in marks is null, usually while computing the average we will use this value as zero. But in case of MySQL, it will not consider the value null, because null is not a value equivalent to zero, but it means there is no value in that column, in that place. Next, we can give a condition for average. So here we have select AVG of marks from student where marks greater than 90. So it will calculate the average of students whose mark is greater than 90. So there are 3 students, 1, 2, 3, and it will calculate the total and then divide by 3. So the average is obtained. Now let us see the next type of function, that is the max function. So max function returns the highest value among the given set of values. It takes either a column name or a column expression involving a particular column from the table. Null values are not included in the calculation. The syntax is select max of column name from table name where condition. So you can see select max of marks from student will return the maximum mark in this table. So the maximum mark is 98. So it returns the maximum mark 98. Next, we can give a condition. Select max of marks from student where marks greater than less than 90. So less than 90, there are 3 values, and among that the greatest value is, maximum value is 79. So it returns the value 79. Let us see how the max works. So the max function select max of marks from student. So it will select the maximum mark from the table. In this table, the maximum mark is 98. So it returns the maximum mark. Now we can select max of marks less than 70. So here only a single value is there, that is 67, which is less than 70. So it returns the maximum mark as 67. Next is the minimum function, min function. It is same as that of the max function, but min function returns the minimum value. So it returns the lowest value ever among the given set of
values. It takes either a column name or a column expression involving a particular column from the table. Null values are not included in the calculation. The syntax is select min of column name from table name where condition. So let us see, we have a table student and we can calculate the minimum value of marks. So select of min of marks from student will return the minimum value in the column. So the column is marks, so the minimum value is 67 and it returns a single value 67. Now if we provide a condition, select min of marks from student where marks greater than 90. If mark is greater than 90, there are two values in that. Minimum value is 93. Marks greater than 90, there are two values, 93 and 98. Among that, the lowest value is 93. So the minimum function returns the value 93. So let us see the example. So this is our table. In that, let us see. Minimum. So it will return the lowest value. It will not consider null. It will return the lowest value. And if we give a condition where marks or where roll number or where marks greater than 70. Sorry, it's marks. Where marks. So it will return the lowest minimum value from the column which is greater than 70. Mark is greater than 70. So the values greater than 70 are 76, 79, 93, 98 and 98. So the lowest value is 76. So it returns the value 76. Now let us see this applied on the name. So it will return the name, lowest name, because based on the ASCII value of the characters. So this min and max function can be used for all type of data. Based on the ASCII value, it returns the lowest. So you can see, select min of marks of name from student. It will return the name Ankit because based on the ASCII value, it has the lowest value. So it returns the min as Ankit Singh. And for if we give here max, then by the alphabetic order, the name Surya is having the highest ASCII value. So it returns max of name as Surya. Now let us see, when we apply this to the date function, what happens. Column name is date of birth, DOB. So this, when the max is applied to date of birth, it will return 17/11/2000. So let us see, 17/11/2000. So it is the largest value among all these values. So if we apply this to min, if we apply min function to date of birth, then it will return the smallest value in the date function. 2 0 to 2000. Next is the count function. So it is used to count the number of values in a column. Count takes one argument or an expression or asterisk as the parameter argument. It returns the number of non-null values in the column. The syntax for count statement is count. Count call of column name from table name where condition. So let us see how the count function works. Select count of star from student. So this para argument here is star. So the count function, when the argument is star, will return the number of rows. So here the argument given is star, so the output will be number of rows in the table, number of records in the table. So how many records are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 records are there, so the output will be 6. And if we give a argument as a column name, then it will return the non-null values in that column. If the argument given, argument means what is given inside the function. If we give argument as the column name, then it will return the number of non-null values in the column. So let us see, select count of marks from student. So marks is the column and it will count the non-null values in that column. So here there are 6 values, out of which 1 is a null value. So it will count 5 values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will return 5 because it is the non-null value in that column. Let us see how the count function works. So this is our table. Count of star from student will return the number of rows, number of records in that table. So here 7 records are there. So it will return 7. Now if we give count any column name, let us give marks because it has a null value. So it returns only 6 because one value in that is null. Now if we can give distinct keyword. So what was the function of distinct keyword? You all studied in your 11th standard. Distinct keyword will return only distinct values. That is, it will not give unique, same values will not be shown. Only the distinct values will be shown. Repeated values will not be shown. So let us see how in this marks function, marks column will return. Select count of distinct marks from student. So here already count of marks will give only 6 value as 6 because it will not count null, and distinct marks gave only the result as 5 because there are two same values. 98 is repeated 2 times, so it will be counted only once, and the rest of the values are not same, are not same. So it will, the distinct function will return only, count only unique values from a column. Also we can give conditions in the select count of marks from student. We can give the condition as where gender equal to female. So I need the marks of only female students. So let us see. There are only 3 female students, but there are 4 female students, but among them one is having null value as the mark. So it counted only 3. It showed the result as 3 because we have given a condition, count, select count of marks from student where gender equal to F. So we need only those students whose gender is F, and we need the count of marks, but there are 4 students and the count will return only non-null value. So it selected out of 4, counted as 1, 2 and 3. It excluded the null value. So we got the output as 3. We have now studied the different functions, different aggregate functions. So aggregate functions are the functions which are applied to a whole of the table, applied to a group. So what are the different aggregate functions we studied? We studied aggregate functions average, sum, max, min and count. Next is an order by close. So this order by close is used to sort the table in ascending or descending order. It just displays, actually in the table itself no change will occur, but what is displayed to us is just ordered. The view of the table shown to us will be just sorted in either ascending or in descending order. For that purpose, for sorting the result in our ascending or descending order, we use the order by close. So order by close can sort the result in either ascending or descending order based on a particular column, based on the particular column. Like in your attendance register, you have seen the names starting from A are in the first position. Then in the last, it goes in the alphabetic order. So the sorting is based on the name. The sorting is done. That is, it starts from names from A to Z. Likewise, we can sort the content of the table based on a particular column like name or roll number or any based on any column we can sort. For that purpose we use order by clause in the select statement. Since it is used in the select statement, only in the view what is displayed to us will be ordered, but in the original content of the table no effect will be there because this is a select statement is a DML statement and it will not affect the structure of the table. Okay, let us see the working of order by clause. So this in order by clause the syntax is select column name from table name, order by column name, where condition. Here let us see how this works on a table. Select what all things we have to display. Select roll number, name, marks from student. How it is to be sorted? It is to be sorted in ascending order based on the name. Here we have not given a keyword DESC or ASC because by default if we do not specify any keyword the sorting will be ascending. By default the sorting, if there is an order by clause, it will sort in ascending order itself. So how let us see how this works. So select roll number, name, marks from student, order by name. So you can see all the names are sorted in ascending order because we have not specified any keyword DESC or ASC. By default it will sort in ascending order. Now let us see if we give here DESC to sort in descending order, then the name which was in here last name comes first and it is sorted in descending order in the alphabetic or in the ASCII based on the ASCII value. It is sorted in descending order. Now we can also sort based on sort by order by roll number. So we have ordered by roll number DESC, descending order. So the roll numbers are sorted from largest to smallest. If we give here ASC or it will sort in ascending order, or if we do not give any value, only just order by roll number. Select roll number, name, marks. Roll number, name, marks from student, order by roll number. It will also sort in ascending order. So I told if there is no keyword ASC or DSC specified, then it will sort by default, it will sort in ascending order. Now we can see a statement. If we want, there are, you can see here, there are, we have sorted students based on their name. No repeated names are there. And if we sort the students based on their marks, if I sort the students based on their marks, you can see all the students are names are also sorted, but here there are two students having the same mark, Deep Singh and Anup. So I want, if students are having the same marks, I want the student whose name is we want to sort the name in ascending order. That is, Anup should in the alphabetic order. That is, Anup should come first and Deep Singh should come after that. So if more than one student are having the same mark, we are sorting based on marks. So we get the result like this. But if two students are having the same mark, we want to sort those students based on the only that much student based on their name in alphabetic order. That is, if we given the result of students in the newspaper, then two students of same school got same marks, then how we will give the result in the newspaper, publish in newspaper? Then we can sort them based on their alphabetic order. That is, the name whose name sort them their names in the alphabetic order, so that the name which is first in the alphabetic order is given first position and then the second, or any way we can give. So here we can give like that. For that we have to give two columns like this: select roll number, name, marks. I have given here marks as marks obtained. That is, using as keyword we can provide alias names. That is, this column will be renamed while displaying as marks obtained from student, order by marks. In marks is ordered in descending order, and if there are similar same marks, then the name should be ordered in ascending order. So how we can write? Order by marks, BESC, comma, name, ASC. So it will produce the result as, marks are sorted in descending order and the name is sorted in ascending order. The rest of the people, the mark are sorted in descending order. And you can see two people are having the same marks. So among them, who will be placed first? The person whose name is in the alphabet, first position in the alphabetic order. So among two students, Anup and Deep Singh, whose names should be first, the name, because the name is sorted in ascending order. So two students having the same mark, the name with which comes first in the alphabetic order will be placed first. Now we can see if here marks obtained from students, order by marks, BESC, name, ASC. Now we can change the marks obtained as ascending and name as descending, or name as ascending, no problem. So here we have the list of all the students' names and the marks obtained. So here repeated marks are there, so the names are also sorted in ascending order. So inside one sorting there is another sorting, so we have to provide the statement like this. First, what is to be sorted? Inner sort is, first sort is this, and after that if there are repeated values, then the sorting should be done like this. Let us see. Group by function. The group by statement is often used with aggregate functions like count, max, min, sum, average to group the result set by one or more columns. This group by groups the rows on the basis of values present in one of the columns and then apply aggregate functions on it. So the example is select gender, comma, count of marks from student, group by gender. So what this group by function does is creates a group based on the particular column. If suppose group by gender means creates a group based on the column gender. So all the values, same values will be grouped into one group and all the other same values will be grouped into other group. So let us see how this group by function works. You can see select gender count of start from student. So it will display the select star from student will display the table. Now let us see how this works, how the group function works. So we are creating a group based on the gender and we can apply our aggregate functions like count, min, max, etc. So you can see when we run this statement group by function, you based on grouping is done based on gender. So here in gender two types of values are there, M and F, male and female. So it creates a group and the count function is applied on that group. First the grouping is performed and then the aggregate function is applied on that group. So you can see there are three values in M and three values for F. There are two groups, F and M. Since I have given here only two columns, in select statement, the output also will have two statements, gender and count of marks. So in F, how many marks are there? How many students' marks are there? 1, 2, 3 in M. In F, there are 4 marks, but count will count only non-null values. So the result is 3. And in M there is, in that group also there are 3 values. So if we select instead of count of marks, if I give here count of star, so what the count of star will do? It will count number of rows in particular group. Select gender count of star from student, group by gender. So there will be two columns, gender and count star. Count of star will count number of rows in each group. Since there is a group by function, it will group the table based on a particular column. So here that column is gender. So based on the column gender, we group the table. So after grouping, you can see here we have given count of star. So it will count the number of rows. Since it is number of rows, it will not check whether there is a null value in any of the column. But it will just count how many rows are there regarding with gender F. So there are 4 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4 rows are there with the gender F. It will count it as 4. And with gender M, there are 3 rows. 1, 2, 3. So it will count as this. So the group by function will create a group based on a particular column. So there are 2 groups because only 2 different types of values are there in gender. If we apply this group by function for roll number, it will create the result as same because there are 7 different values in this. So let us see how the group by function is applied to roll number. So in roll number there are 7 roll numbers. So there are, I have given here gender and count of star. So it is given, the output is also gender and count of star. So in here the first one, there are 7 groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 groups are there because we are grouping by roll number. So there is no group, because all the values are different. If there are repeated values only, it will be created as a group. Here you can see repeated values. M is repeated 3 times. F is repeated 4 times. So M and F are there. Only two type of values are there. But here 7 type of values are there. So the group created is 7 groups are created. And in each group, first group only one value, second group only one value. So it is displayed here. Next is having clause in group by function. So having clause are used in select statement to filter the records by specifying a condition which a group returns. So we have used the where clause to filter the items based on a particular condition. But this where clause were used in single row functions. But this having clause can be used in aggregate functions, in group by, in groups. So having clause can be used in group by function. So let us see the syntax of having clause. Select column name from table name, group by columns having condition. So we have an example. Select gender count of star from student, group by gender having count greater than 3. So let us run this in MySQL. So you can see select gender count of star from student, group by gender having count of star greater than 3. So we have two groups. We created here two groups. And in that, what should be displayed? Count of star value should be greater than 3. So there is only one group in that where the condition is satisfied. The group having gender as F will satisfy that condition. So it is displayed here. discount. So to give a condition, to extract values based on a condition in a group, we use having clause. Suppose in the same, if we use instead of count of star less than 3, if we use equal to 3, then it will extract the value where count of star is equal to 3. So all the group having gender M have the value count of star as 3. So it will return the output like this. So having clause are used to extract values based on in group by function in a group. It has the same purpose as that of the where condition, where clause, but the having is used in groups and where condition is applied in single row functions. Also in aggregate functions also, but not in groups. For groups, the same function of where is done by that of having clause. Having clause are used in groups and where is used in single row and aggregate functions, but not in groups. To provide a condition in groups, we use having clause. Now let us see the difference between a where and the having clause. So where works for single row and aggregate functions, and having works for group functions. So this is our table, and from that what we need, all the students whose marks are greater than 70. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 students whose marks are greater than 70. And among them, we create a group. So we have total 5 students, and the group created is F is greater than F and M. So female, how many students? 2 students only, because one student is having marks as null and the other student is having mark less than 70. So we need only those students whose marks are greater than 70. So when we do the statement select gender count of star from student where marks greater than 70 group by gender, the output is like this. Here we have 2 groups, in that the students have got marks greater than 70 and the count is in female 2 students and male 3 students. Now when we apply a having function, let us see what is the output. So having sum of marks greater than 100, so then also the same output, because the sum of marks will be calculated as female 2 students, so their sum will be calculated 76 plus 98, so the sum is greater than 100. And in male there are 2 students and their sum is also greater than 100. So let us give the sum as 150. Here if I give the sum as 180, then it will filter only those records whose in only those groups whose total sum is greater than 180. So we can see the group containing gender M has only the sum greater than 180. This group has sum less than 180. So the having clause filtered only those record which satisfied this condition. So to provide a condition in groups, we use having clause. To provide a condition in group, we use having clause. And to provide a condition in single or aggregate functions without groups, we use where. So if we use both where and having, first the where condition will check for each of the records. So here marks greater than 70 means it will check for each of these records whose marks are greater than 70 and collect all these records whose marks are greater than 70. And after collecting, it groups the record based on the gender and creates a group like this. Then after that, we apply a condition on the group. So that condition can be applied by the clause having. By having clause, we apply that condition. What is the condition? Sum of marks should be greater than 180. Sum of marks, sum is also an aggregate function, so it will calculate the total of that group. So in this group, the total is, there are two students and the total is 76 plus 79, which is less than 180. And in case of male, the value is 93 plus 98 plus 98. So it is always greater than 180. So it displayed only this value. Okay, thank you.